a little bit later, another person saw him and said, "You were with him, you were with him." And he said, "No, I wasn't with him." And about an hour later, another guy saw him and said, "I know you were with him. You were one of his disciples. You're even a Galilean." And Peter started denying him. He says, "Man, you're wrong." He says, "I don't even know who he is." Peter never thought he'd betray Jesus. He loved Jesus. But he messed up just like you did. He did the wrong thing. But you know what? There's real good news.
There is?
Yes. The day we call Good Friday is the day that Jesus died on the cross and was buried. The day after the Sabbath, the third day, that's a Sunday, God raised Christ from the dead. And Christ taught his disciples for the next 40 days. Now, they understood that Jesus was the Son of God who died for the forgiveness of sins. And if we believe and have faith that Jesus is God's Son, we can ask Him to forgive our sins and come into our heart. And He will not only save us from our sins and forgive our sins, but we'll have the peace in knowing that we will have eternal life with Him. And Peter, would you like to pray with me? God is always ready to forgive our sins. We pray to Him in the name of Jesus.
Thank you.
Will you please forgive me?
Sure, I forgive you. We've been friends for a long time.
Oh, you guys are great. Everyone needs forgiveness at the time of time.
To begin, we ask Jesus to forgive us of all our sins and to give us a relationship with Him. Who else?
Yes, and sometimes we sin against one another as friends or family.
He got forgiven
us. Each one of you is special, created by God for His purposes and for our good. In Jeremiah 29:11 in the Bible, God says, I know what I'm doing. I have it all planned out. Plans to take care of you and not abandon you. Plans to give you the future that you hope for.
Man, that's good.
A real friend's pretty cool too. Hey, look, I think it's time for a pretty good news. Where do you live?
I think I
you come. sure you'll all join me in saying that's one of the greatest messages you've ever heard.
Amen.
There's nothing I can say to add to this. I'm just so filled with His Spirit. What on earth? God is so good. And I asked Him to stay up here for two reasons. I want you to see them. The other reason is when we make our circle around the church today, we're going to need all the room that we can get. We may have to crowd up just a little bit, but let's make our prayer circle and we'll be dismissed.